Lisa Bloom is with us tonight. She is the lawyer who drove Bill O'Reilly out of Fox News. Now, many people drove Bill O'Reilly out, including, of course, the women who brought sexual harassment charges against him. Wendy Walsh drove O'Reilly out because she was one of the few women who could tell her story publicly because she had not entered a legal settlement with Bill O'Reilly in which O'Reilly purchased her silence for millions of dollars. Wendy Walsh was guided in telling her story first to the New York Times and then on this program and others by Lisa Bloom. Lisa Bloom was the last lawyer standing against Bill O'Reilly when he got kicked out the door at Fox News today. That boot kicking Bill O'Reilly out the door was on Lisa Bloom's foot. When Bill O'Reilly suddenly left on a vacation in the middle of this controversy, in the middle of the week, we wondered on this program whether he would ever be coming back.
Often around this time of year, I grab some vacation because it's spring and Easter time. Last fall, I booked a trip that should be terrific. Not going to tell you where it is, but we have a contest on BillO'Reilly.com. Guess where Bill's going. I'll have a full report when I return.
And now we know where he went, and now we know he's never coming back. 18 days. That's how long it took for Bill O'Reilly to be fired by Fox News, after the New York Times' devastating report on at least $13 million Fox News and Bill O'Reilly paid to at least five women who brought sexual harassment claims against Bill O'Reilly. When the New York Times story broke, advertisers started leaving O'Reilly's show. Protesters then instantly activated on social media and elsewhere and convinced dozens and dozens more advertisers to leave Bill O'Reilly's show, and advertisers left every day. The voices of those protesters were heard by the advertisers, and today, that voice of protest won. They rose up against Bill O'Reilly and they won. The parent company of Fox News issued this statement today. After a thorough and careful review of the allegations, the company and Bill O'Reilly have agreed that Bill O'Reilly will not be returning to the Fox News channel. Much of the information in the New York Times report about Bill O'Reilly was already known, including the most devastating case against him from 2004, which included transcripts of phone calls Bill O'Reilly made to a Fox News employee. The woman receiving those calls said it sounded as if Bill O'Reilly was doing something other than just talking on the phone when he was telling her about all of the sexual things that he wanted to do to her. Those phone calls cost Fox News $9 million. And they occurred 13 years ago. Fox News knew everything it needed to know to fire Bill O'Reilly 13 years ago. And they didn't do it because it wasn't in the value system of Fox News, and Bill O'Reilly was their big star, making more than any other host on Fox News with bigger ratings than anyone else on Fox News. We now know that the man running Fox News, Roger Ailes, was at least as bad as Bill O'Reilly and possibly much, much worse. He was driven out of Fox News last year once the basic outlines of his multiple offense sexual harassment lifestyle at Fox News was revealed. It was impossible to get fired for sexual harassment at Fox News under Roger Ailes running Fox News. He was the sexual harasser in chief at Fox News. It was also impossible to file a complaint for sexual harassment through the HR department. No one did. No woman during the time of Roger Ailes and Bill O'Reilly filed a formal complaint through the Fox News complaint system, not one, because obviously no one trusted it. And they were right not to trust that system run by Roger Ailes. Lisa Bloom advised her client, Wendy Walsh, to tell her story to the New York Times before she told her story to Fox News. And when Wendy Walsh's story of sexual harassment was published in the New York Times, one of Bill O'Reilly's lawyers threatened to sue Wendy Walsh for defamation of character. And that's when you stepped in and helped deliver a message to Fox News. I put out this tweet saying, "Hey, Bill O'Reilly, please sue me too because I believe Wendy Walsh," and I asked you to retweet it so that Fox News would see your response, and 53,000 of you retweeted that to Fox News. 53,000. And just by comparison to the tweeter-in-chief, Donald Trump's biggest retweet today got 12,900 retweets. Fox News got your message in that tweet and in many, many others and in many other ways and in protesters outside of the building. Fox News got the message. 18 days. Lisa Bloom wasn't finished after she helped Wendy Walsh tell her story. Lisa Bloom kept coming at Bill O'Reilly with more women's stories. Yesterday, Lisa Bloom revealed the story of a black woman at Fox News who says she was sexually harassed by Bill O'Reilly. And Fox News decided they just couldn't take another day. After what Lisa Bloom did to Fox News last night, I asked, how many more bad news days will Fox endure? And I speculated that O'Reilly would be out by Friday. I was wrong. Fox News couldn't take another day of what Lisa Bloom was doing to them. Bill O'Reilly's lawyers threatened Lisa Bloom and her client. And in the immortal words of Mitch McConnell, nevertheless, she persisted. Joining us now, Lisa Bloom, the managing attorney at the Bloom Firm. She represents Wendy Walsh and two other women who have accused Bill O'Reilly of sexual harassment. Lisa, before the New York Times story came out, you knew that Saturday, that Friday, that it was going to be out in the Sunday Times. We didn't. We got the Sunday Times. We read it. What did you think was going to happen when I and millions of others read that story?
Well, I knew people were going to be very affected by the story, but that wasn't going to be enough. We had to keep this story alive in the media, and we had to get other accusers, and we had to have a game plan. So I'm an attorney, but I also do a lot of media, and I understand how both the law and media work. I also understand how the attorneys for Fox News work, because I've had other cases against them. And so I came up with a plan with Wendy Walsh, and God bless her, she was willing to do it. She was very, very scared, and you see her on TV. She's very good, but behind the scenes, she was very nervous, and I told her I would fight with her.
What was she afraid of?
We were going to win this. She was afraid of Bill O'Reilly coming after her, taking her home, you know, suing her.
She was afraid of what happened.
She's a single mom.
The threats from Bill O'Reilly's lawyers.
Yes.
She anticipated that.
The first thing was she got that letter. Mm-hmm. She sent it to me. I wrote a strong letter back saying, don't you dare ever contact her again. I represent her. All
this was a letter from Bill O'Reilly's lawyer to her after she went public.
Immediately when the New York Times story broke. Mm-hmm. You got, you know, nasty lawyer's letter, which doesn't mean anything to me.
Right.
I get a lot of nasty lawyer's letters. But to a regular person, to a single mom who's not a wealthy person, that was very scary. And anyway, I told him basically drop dead and talk to me if you have anything to say. And miraculously, I never heard anything further. But we came up with a plan, and the plan was we have got to keep this story alive in the news. This cannot be a one-day story that blows over. That's what Fox News wants. And so, Wendy, we need to do a press conference. Of course, she was very nervous about that, but I walked her through everything that we were going to do. We had the press conference. I had already gone over with her witnesses, her evidence. You know, my entire law firm has been devoted to this for many weeks. We've really put aside everything else. The plan was we got to bring down Bill O'Reilly, and we know how to do it. So we then had a conundrum, which is that her claims were time barred. She can't sue. What can we do? Well, as I was scratching my head and trying to figure that out,
her claims,
Fox News gave us a wonderful
gift. Statute of limitations had passed on her claims, so
right,
she wouldn't be able to sue.
They were from 2013,
right.
And in New York, it's a 3-year statute of limitations. But then a wonderful gift came out of heaven, and that was Fox News saying, none of these women have ever called the hotline.
Yes.
And I thought to myself, aha, the hotline. I happen to have a copy of the Fox News handbook in my file from a previous case. I pulled it out, and there was the number for the hotline. And also, all of the internal rules, which were no time deadlines for calling the hotline and no requirement that you have to be a current employee.
That's the video of you and Wendy calling the Fox News hotline. Right,
so
there.
I was concerned that they might say we didn't do it, so we made a video.
And then we all had that video to show on these programs, which we did.
I thought you might like it.
Yes, and it worked. But so you were confident from the start that this could be, that Wendy Walsh's story and the aftermath of it handled correctly could bring down Bill O'Reilly.
I've been
this is someone who survived 13 years ago a worse case where there were tapes that became public.
I knew Andrea Macris in 2004. I knew about the allegations of the tapes. I knew what she went through. I knew that Bill O'Reilly sued her. How dare he?
Mm-hmm.
And I have been angry ever since, frankly. And to discover that more women have come out with similar tapes of him and the sexually disgusting activities that he was doing on those tapes, which I probably can't say on your show. I mean, this is appalling that he was still there. I was very motivated to bring him down. Somebody had to do it, and that had to be us, right? So I had Wendy call into the hotline, and I knew that that would trigger their legal obligation to do an investigation. And we made the video to protect ourselves, to make sure that it was recorded. We released the video publicly so they would be shamed into doing the investigation immediately. A day went by. I tweeted, you know, it's been a day. We still haven't heard from you, Fox News. And a couple days later, they did contact us. They asked Wendy for an interview. She did an interview. I had other accusers reaching out to me already, which I also knew would happen, because these guys who are so arrogant and powerful, there's always multiple accusers, and they're always afraid.
These were not women you knew about before Wendy went public, but
right.
You believed when Wendy goes public, others will call.
You have to come out publicly in a big way so that they will call you. Right? I, as an attorney, cannot call people, and I wouldn't have known who to call anyway, right? They have to call us. And it also takes time to vet their stories, right? We as attorneys have to talk to their witnesses, get emails, get any kind of evidence that exists. You know, you call witnesses, most of the time, they don't call you back. You have to bug them. It takes time.
You, even after, right after it was announced today that Bill O'Reilly was out, you then revealed that you had yet another woman with a complaint against Bill O'Reilly. Take me through the complaint that you referred to today. I'd like to hear that one, and I'd like to hear the complaint that you revealed yesterday. What strikes us, if we're looking at the history of this, the real final straw was the complaint you released yesterday.
Yes.
Fox News did not attempt to survive another day after that one. So, in fact, let's begin with that one, the one that you revealed publicly yesterday. Tell us that story.
So,
that woman has not revealed herself publicly, so you're the only one who can tell us this story.
Yes. So immediately after the story came out with Wendy, I got an email from this African-American woman who lives in North Carolina who said that she, too, had been sexually harassed by Bill O'Reilly, but she was very, very scared. She was a clerical worker. She's not somebody like us who's comfortable talking on TV. She was absolutely terrified to come forward. But she's been living with this angst and anguish since 2008. So as an attorney, I knew that we had to get emotional support for her. I asked her, who's your emotional support person? My sister. Great. We reached out to her sister, made contact, got the sister to give her the emotional support. We've been talking to her for about a week. Finally, I realized I have to go out to North Carolina and meet with her in person.
And
what
was her experience? What happened
to her?
So her
experience was that she was a clerical worker for 6 months at Fox News, she says. She worked for a different individual who she said was a very good boss, but Bill O'Reilly was on the same floor, and she said he would never speak to her in any way, not a hi, not a how you doing. The only comments he would ever make to her were oh yeah, looking good. He would very noticeably leer and stare at her cleavage, look at her legs if she was standing up and walking by. He had a nickname for her, which was Hot Chocolate, and as an African-American woman, she found that very offensive. It got to the point where she was afraid to be alone on the floor.
He would say that repeatedly to her, that hot chocolate?
He would say it a couple of times to her. And she was afraid of him. You know, and people might say, well, how can you take some of these...
He's a really big guy. I'm not sure people know.
He's very tall.
He's 6'4" or 5".
He's very powerful. And he would also yell and scream at people in the office. I mean, everybody knows he's a very temperamental person.
People have seen the video of him screaming and off camera and things.
Right. Yeah. So she was really afraid. She needed this job. She did not want to lose the job. And other than Bill O'Reilly, she says she liked the job. She thought she could rise up at Fox News and do well there. So she just didn't say anything. But she lived with the stress. And I talked to her sister, her boyfriend at the time, and her roommate at the time, and they all corroborate that she started the job as a happy-go-lucky person, very optimistic. And as the months went by, she would come home constantly complaining about Bill O'Reilly sexually harassing her, and she became very depressed and withdrawn, and it really changed her as a person. And that change continues today.
And tell us about the story that the woman that you had today that you talked about after O'Reilly was already out the door.
Caroline Heldman, I can release her name. She was a regular unpaid contributor on O'Reilly's show from about 2008 to 2011. She doesn't have a sexual harassment claim. She has a sex discrimination claim. She says that she did a pre-taped interview with him. He always pre-tapes, apparently. And they got into an argument, as one does on cable news. He called her hysterical. Don't be hysterical. And she gave it back to him and said, you know, that's a very sexist term. And he said, no, it isn't. And she said, yes, it is a gendered history to call a woman hysterical. That's a very sexist thing. Please don't say that to me. Well, that part of the interview was cut out, and she was frozen out, and she was never on the show again. And this is after years of being on the show. And so I explained to her that I felt that that was retaliation for complaining about sex discrimination, and that was worthy of calling into the complaint line. And so we were literally calling into the complaint line on that call today when the news broke that Bill O'Reilly had been fired.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.